So let me go ahead now and sort of come back and review some of the things we've covered already. So this is sort of a summary or a cheat sheet, or call it what you will. So thinking about what happens in the aggregate demand, aggregate supply model, and then how that translates over into the Phillips curve model. So, if we have an increase in aggregate demand, that's going to mean higher prices and higher output. And in the Phillips curve model, that translates as higher inflation and lower unemployment. So that is a movement along the short-run Phillips curve, movement along short-run Phillips curve, and it's a movement up and to the left. So a movement in that sort of northwestern direction. If we have a decrease in aggregate demand, then we're going to have the opposite. We're going to have lower prices and lower GDP. So that's going to mean lower inflation and higher unemployment. So that's a movement along the short-run Phillips curve. And instead of a movement up and to the left, this is a movement down and to the right. What about changes in short-run aggregate supply? A leftward shift or decrease in short-run aggregate supply is going to tend to cause both higher prices and lower GDP. So that's just pretty much a bad thing. So that means we are having higher inflation and higher unemployment. And we can't do that by shifting along a fixed short-run Phillips curve. So we shift the whole short-run Phillips curve shift it to the right. And if we have a rightward shift or an increase in short-run aggregate supply, then we have a fall in the general price level and an increase in GDP. So we both have a fall in inflation and a decrease in unemployment. So we're going to shift the whole Phillips curve, short-run Phillips curve, to the right. Sorry, to the left, excuse me. So that's your summary of the main ways in which this can happen. Now, remember that the short-run aggregate supply curve crosses the long-run aggregate supply curve at the expected price level. So, because essentially all of our explanations for why the short-run aggregate supply curve slopes up come down to people being slow to adjust to price changes or slow to notice price changes and that kind of stuff. So the intersection here is at the expected price level. And if firms come to expect higher prices, over the course of the year, they'll start building some of those higher prices into their current prices so that they won't be sort of caught unawares. And we will have this intersection move up here. So short run aggregate supply 2 with higher expected prices. The analogous idea in the Phillips curve model is that the short run Phillips curve crosses the long run Phillips curve at the expected inflation rate. So, this is why central banks and other sort of economic policymakers spend a lot of time worrying about expected inflation or the expected price level. Because we end up having something of a self-fulfilling prophecy. If expected inflation goes up, then this point of intersection shifts up, and we actually get a worse trade-off. We get either more inflation or more unemployment or both. So, price and inflation expectations are key. And they're key to having a good Phillips curve. Generally, notice a Phillips curve that is farther to the left gets us less inflation and less unemployment. So it gives us a better trade-off. A Phillips curve over here, this is a bad Phillips curve, this is a better Phillips curve. So price and inflation expectations are key to having a good Phillips curve, a good short-run Phillips curve. And again, that's why central banks worry so much about inflation expectations. Let me go ahead and stop there, and in our next video segment, we'll go through a little bit of the macroeconomic history of the United States.